you wait for me on the left-hand side here next to the table, this little tree next to the table on your left is a sandalwood tree. Okay.
Come on up to this area here. Close it up tight so everybody can come in. Is everybody in?
I'm not, just a minute. Yeah.
Okay. If you follow the torch, and I'll explain as we go past. Yes. Just over here to your left, just follow the torch, you can see the shape of the moon. When the moon's at that cycle, it means that it's a very good fishing time. See the fish?
Yeah.
So the Aborigines put those inscriptions on there. You've still got to remember these are very ancient places. By following the torch and right up through to the ceilings, you'll start to see the hand stencils. There's quite a few of them if you look very carefully. Just follow the actual torch. And the hand stencils are put there so that it indicates a boy becoming a man. If you follow right through to the rooftops through here, you can see them up in there. There are also human figures indicating the Aboriginal people, warriors. All the way up through to the roof. A lot of them have faded because these caves are hundreds and hundreds of years old. They've also lit fires. There are also, you can see more over here, the hand stencils, and also the shape of a human. There are also indicators of namaholes. You can see another hand here with a human, with a boy there. You can see a boy. Namaholes are Aboriginal watering holes. And also there are figures of kangaroos and emus. And Namahole is a watering hole for the Aborigines. What they would do is they would get go to a natural fault line. Where that natural fault line intersected, they would dig a great big hole into the rock, chipping it away until they dug a 6 to 8 foot deep hole. They would line it with sand, and then they would wait for Mother Nature to rain. As it rains, because it's on a natural fault line, the water runs straight into the hole. They would then put this information down in the cave, as we saw. They would put the information in the cave, so when the tribes come through, they know exactly where to look for that particular hole. So you could be out there at 50 degree heat, a white man, dying of thirst, and only just a few yards away, there's millions of gallons of drinking water. And you don't know, because you can't recognise the sign.
The rocks that you can see here are very smooth. These are also 2,700 million years. That's been caused by the water. This is an open cave. The water comes through here, up over those rocks, and away. So that's been caused over that period of a long, long time. There was no white man here. There wasn't even Aborigines here. We're talking 2,700 million years. The Aborigines have only been here 100,000 years. We've been here 2.5 minutes. So that gives you some indication what the white man, we don't know much because we haven't been here long enough. So this has all been caused by Mother Nature over that period of time. The most dangerous thing is when you look out here, you can't see anything. You think you can't see anything. But out here there are snakes, scorpions, spiders, lizards. There are all sorts of creatures, pythons. And you go walking over the rocks and you disturb them and they can bite you. So you never ever go walking over these rocks and up around through these areas. It's quite dangerous because you get bitten by something. You don't know what you've been bitten by. You can't see it. And it could be, they're all deadly snakes. So you've got to be very careful. You don't go walking into any of these caves because they're dangerous. Okay, take your photos and then we'll